I can't believe it, Abby. There you are.
There's Ari.
Hello, man.
There's Ari.
You know, from last month to this month, he has grown physically.
He likes
it.
Everything goes in the mouth.
I know, I know.
Yeah. Oh boy, you big
the
boy!
Most beautiful thing we ever had in our family.
Yeah, big boy.
You agree, Eric? You agree? He's the most beautiful thing we had in our family.
He's one of the most beautiful things.
He thinks your other great grandchildren are very important too. Yeah. He thinks your other great grandchildren are also important.
Yeah, I'm looking at him.
Oh, boy.
You know,
baby.
He is beautiful.
Yeah. I fly too,
there.
You might have flown in the plane, but I fly in the air.
Oh, yeah.
I fly in the air.
He's not a year old yet.
Oh, no.
He's not a year old.
No, he's only 7.5 months.
Who knows? I don't know.
He's just over half a year.
Yeah?
He's just more than half a year.
Oh, just half a year. Okay. Okay, he's like, I'm
full garçon. Well, he's déjà beau. Come to Tata. Be careful, Tata. He's heavy when you pick him up like that. You're going to wear your arms out.
Yes. Oh, my goodness. Where's Daddy?
He loves you so much.
Oh, I
I'm
love
so
him.
Glad you get to see him.
Oh, boy, big boy. Big boy. And he's got more teeth than I got.
Yeah. It didn't take much pear.
He's going to have hazel eyes. That's what you're going to have. I love the cheeks.
People are going to say, where does he get his eyes from? And we're going to say, Tata Anna.
Look at the smiley face. Where's Grandpa? There's Grandpa. Whee! I love you. I push you on the back. And I have you on the leg. This is my song. You love them.
You have a special way with hair.
Where's Grandpa?
Darn, that is not too much hair.
It's perfect.
He's a good boy. Here you are. Sit down there. He's going to walk soon. Where's Mommy? I love you.
Are you telling Tata something?
I love you. Okay.
You're going to bite me.
He's a beautiful boy.
Thank you. Thank God.
He's a beautiful boy.
All those prayers you had to Hashem for us to have a baby.
He likes the hat.
He likes the wings on your hat.
Yeah.
You want to hold Pear's hand?
Hey, Pear, what do the wings on your hat mean?
Look at all the flowers!
Eric's asking you a question.
Huh?
Eric asked, what does the wings on your hat mean? What are the wings on your hat?
What are they from?
Oh, well, no, the Air Force. World War II. And then, of course, the...
You were in World War II, Pear?
Eric's making a recording. He's asking you questions.
Okay, well,
when
you grow up, and you get big and long, and then you can fly the plane, the big plane.
Pear, what kind of planes did you fly?
Mommy, he wants your hat on him.
Repeat my question.
What kind of planes did you fly?
17 and B-24s.
Oh, yeah, we had lots.
Yeah?
Oh, you like them?
Oh,
what? You
want to
make another noise?
You were hungry again?
Oh, boy.
What year was the war in, Tonton?
19.
1920.
The war?
He was
23
years old.
So it was 1943?
Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly. 42, 43.
And where were you stationed?
Oh, I was stationed all over the world. I started out in private lessons in Texas, Fort Christie. And then went to Bagerfield, Washington, and flew the four engine bombers. And then after that.
Yeah, you have a book with all that.
Yeah, you want to hear what I'm saying.
Yeah.
And you might be. But you don't have to go. The wars are over. Now you can have fun.
Can we get
this hat? Okay. What? Oh, yeah, I forgot.
Pear, when were you in Burma?
When my?
In Burma.
Oh, that would be in 43.
What happened in Burma?
I didn't meet you yet.
What happened in Burma?
Well, we had a fight with the Japs. And the Japs,
the Japanese, the Philippines,
and General Doolittle said, I will be back when he left. And he did come back. After we took the whole place back again. And little guys like that didn't have to go to war. No more war. No more shoot 'em up. These guys, cowboys and Indians.
I love this chicken.
Cowboys and Indians, that's the only war you went for. But we always get guys like Hitler and Mussolini and a couple of others too. Now we got this guy from Syria who thinks he's a big shot. No, no. No, we're going to take him down so these big guys like him won't have to go bang.
Yeah.
No more shooting.
Thank you.
No more food.
Yeah, he likes
it. Hey, can check on him, feet.
Give him a
oh, boy.
He wants to get it. I think he's ready for a
he's getting there.
Yeah, and when you fly an airplane, a big airplane, with four engines.
Ooh.
Oh, boy.
You can then you'll have wings like this. That.
Hey, I'm winking. Yes,
yes. And Pear, what year did you go to?
Fly the passengers.
Pear,
we're going to take them from New York to California.
Okay. That sounds fun.
Yeah. Come on, shooting.
Pear, what year did you go to Casablanca, Morocco?
Well, we had a fuel up, refuel.
Now you just have to fuel the plane to go. You land it to fuel the plane to go home.
Yeah.
Okay.
And we brought up the same planes we flew during the war.
I know the story better than you.
What?
I know the story because I was kind of worried when you were going back home the same day.
Oh, yeah.
No, because he...
But then...
The plane that they were going to fly... At the last minute, I would never have met him. He had some repairs to be done before they take it off because it was a big trip.
No, you were going to fly and have
right,
fun.
Morley? You were going on a big trip so they couldn't take that plane until they fixed it. So
yeah.
You stayed 7 days more instead
yeah.
of leaving.
Yes.
And that's when I met him.
Yeah.
Where did you guys meet?
At the airbase.
Yeah, at the airbase. Her.
I was working there.
Where?
Her boss's name was.
Casablanca American Airbase.
Huh? Her boss's name was Zachary.
Oh, the whole thing is how exactly we met is a miracle. Miracle from God. And Morley, I had this big office from there to here with an old bureau, you know, many. And he came to our, he probably doesn't remember this. He came to our, to talk to our office, which we had a lot of people, to talk to our sergeant about somebody from that office has to buy meat because they were getting guests from Casablanca to come and have lunch, and they had to have it kosher. And so, I was
he working, remembers better than
I
do.
I was working in the same office where he was sitting, and he came in with the name Zachary on his jacket. And I flipped out, not because I thought anything happened, was going to happen. He says, I said to him, the first word, you're not an American if your name is Zachary. And he turned around and showed me his flying jacket with his name in the back.
And no, name in the front, yeah. Flag in the back.
And he was trying to tell me that he is. I said, not if you're Zachary, because you have Zachary right here.
The man,
listen to this, the man that was named Zachary at the base was at the time the director of all the civilian personnel that he hired. His name, Zachary. So that's why, you know, well, I knew Zachary was a Moroccan name, definitely. And so, question after question telling him he's not an American. See, I haven't changed. I have not changed. Morley does not tell you that I haven't changed, because that's what I do now.
What year did you guys meet?
Eh?
What year did you meet?
1937, 1947, 1957, something is 1957.
What year did you get married?
Well, the same year, in November.
Yeah.
The same year in November.
I think it was 47.
And you...
What year are we today?
In the United States, I came here.
We were engaged.
We were engaged.
And the congressman I knew. And so I called him on the phone. No, sure, send me all the papers. And yeah, we'll sign them.
We didn't have the, I didn't have
and
the reality.
Get her permission.
The immigrant had no priority. If I was married to him, I would have had the priority to go.
So I said we were engaged.
You know that, Jackie?
We were married.
Did I know what?
Eh?
That you didn't have the priority?
No.
And we were going to have dinner, baby, like him.
Yeah. How old were you? How old were you when you got engaged?
I think I was 21.
And how old was he?
I am concerned.
23. He's only 2 years older than me.
And how old are you today? How old are you today?
Today?
Uh-huh.
Me?
Yeah.
I must be about...
Beep, beep. Did you get your flu shot?
16.
Oh, yeah.
More. I was born in 23, so you can figure it out.
How old is Pear?
What?
How old is Pear?
Pear was only 2 or 3 years older than me.
No, how old is he today?
Today?
Mm-hmm.
I really don't know.
What?
How old are you today?
Well, you don't know? I was born October 7th, 1920.
Yeah,
24. I should have stopped.
93 years
93.
Old.
93.
Tata, do you remember where you lived in Morocco?
When I left, what?
Tata, do you remember where you lived in Morocco?
Yeah.
Where did you live?
Le rue de quoi?
Le rue de quoi? Le rue de Commandant Provent.
Yeah.
Do you remember what number?
Yeah, that's
No, not anymore. I used to know. my house.
Yeah. And who lived in this house?
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
And you like our garden?
There when my mom.
Oh, yeah. And at night, the lights go up.
Really?
What year did he pass away? What year did he pass away?
Everything there was taken care of by us.
November 7th.
You're doing a lovely job.
And I see your lemon over there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And
how
there.
Did you know I was right?
I don't know.
You know how I know I was right?
And how do you know?
That's when I graduated from school.
On both sides of the
that
wall.
Same summer. And I had a school in the house out for the here. Kids.
And
I see, used to go to my brother Solomon and my sister and pick up over
right, the right.
Where they used to live,
and
bring them to my house and teach
them. Oh, wow.
Wow. And how many brothers and sisters did you have?
You look at that,
at that time, we were four of us.
People around
but there was also Hanania and Salomon.
I'm watching my daddy over there, my papa.
Benjamin.
Yeah,
Well, let's start with your with Mimirika. Yeah, but the first time he had
two or three.
And Hanania.
Yeah.
And another one.
Mimiklara. Huh? Mimiklara.
Sulika.
Sulika.
And
Clara.
Tata Esther.
You got another foot.
Not Esther, the young one. Another one.
Mm-hmm. Clara. And then the second, and the next children's were.
He's gonna have more hair.
Who are your brothers and sisters?
My brother Benjamin. Jacques, the guy.
How did he die?
In the bicycle.
Was he the oldest?
Was he the oldest child?
Yeah.
Wow.
And after Jack, there was
Benjamin.
Benjamin, and then after Benjamin, and then after you,
Mary,
and then after Mary.
That
was all her children.
My mother had a lot of kids.
She got all kinds of
oranges.
And
you know, when I was
young. Gotten, I
how old were you when you left Morocco?
Wow.
And where did you go?
To Paris.
Yeah.
I went from Nice, I took the train to Paris.
Rawr.
From Paris, I took the boat to Cherbourg.
Oh,
come
just from
Cherbourg.
I have to look
in New York? And then where did you go?
Now you're asking me questions to see where my brain is at?
No.
I got something
for
you. Well, I am surprised that I remember these things.
After New York, where did you go?
After what?
After New York, where did you go? And then you moved to where?
Before you.
New Jersey or Tampa?
No. I lived in New Jersey at that time.
And then after New Jersey, where did you move to? Tampa. And then after Tampa, where did you move to? But after Tampa, didn't you move to San Diego?
Yeah.
And what year did you move to San Diego? What year did you move to San Diego?
What year?
Oh, what year?
because we were in the apartment.